six at it down. Greetings again, Six Adders. Today I'm highlighting another of my favorite parts of Trogdor the Board Game. And this time, it's Trogdor's Fiery Rage. Trogdor! This occurs at the end of the game if you have not successfully burninated the countryside, the peasants, and the thatched roof cottages. We're catching up with Trogdor after he's just completed his moves, and I of course chose to play with my chiaroscuro Trogdor. I hope you'll do the same, Six Adders. Roll a sad six, represent. So now it's the countryside's turn. So we pick a movement card, and first we spawn our peasants. Now the card has two peasants, but we've only got one on the board, and it demands another peasant. So we take one peasant from the trog meter, and he is spawned from any unburdenated cottage. I choose this one for reasons I do not care to disclose. And now it's time to move them in the spirit of my favorite unproduced Don Bluth film, Peasants Goes West. West, west. And now it's time to move the knights and archers. So we look back at our movement card, and they are all going to go north, east, east, north, north. Oh, and this one scores a direct hit on Trogdor. We lose another peasant from our peasant meter. He goes over here into our new The Void card, where all the peasants that you lose from taking damage go. So let's see what happens with the other two. North, east, east, north, north. And the trog hammer, north, east, east, north, north. And last, the archers. North, east, east, north, north. But remember, the archers shoot arrows in both directions. Arrowed! Trogdor's taken damage from a knight or archer on an empty trog meter. So this triggers Trogdor's fiery rage. Trogdor! Trogdor doesn't lose, he rage quits. We will draw five consecutive movement cards. Trogdor will follow the movement path on each of those. He gets automatic perma-burnination. He gets wraparound movement. He automatically kills peasants, knights, and the troghammer. If he can burninate the entire countryside, all the peasants, and all the thatched roof cottages, then he is victorious, and then probably takes a really long nap. I would. I have to take like a 3-hour nap just after eating a bowl of Tom Kha Gai soup. Okay, so here we go. We draw our first card, and Trogdor moves, burninating the tile he is on and any knights or peasants on it. See ya, knight. East, east, cottage burninated. North, knight gone. East, card number two. East, sorry, Troghammer. East, north, west, north. This is looking good. On to card number three. North, another cottage. West, peasant gone. West, north, already burninated. Number four, south, west. Give my regards to the void. West, south. And for some reason, the archers always escape. I don't know, they're wearing flame retardant Robin Hood tunics, maybe. Oh, we're so close, I can taste it. Like a bowl of Tom Kha Gai soup. Last one, card number five. We have got to burninate that last countryside tile or we do not win. West, north, north, west. Whoa, we did it. Trogdor's fiery rage was a success. And even if it's not, it's still a really entertaining way to lose the game. Though by adding fun to losing the game, it kind of takes the fun out of losing the game. Which, as a big fan of devastating losses myself, is one of my few criticisms of the game. They could make it hurt a little more.
I'd make it hurt a little more.
Whoa! Stop throwing the box at me.
Okay, I'll switch to typewriters.